already arrived. Would you like me to bring her in? Or I'll get her.
Excuse me. Hi, I'm Karen Wexler. I'm here to see Dean Walsh for the scholarship.
You were expected 20 minutes ago, Miss Wexler.
I'm really, really sorry, but I had transportation problems.
I don't believe that Dean Walsh can see you now.
Just for a few minutes?
It would disrupt his schedule for the rest of the afternoon. The dean just asked me to bring in the next applicant. I'm sorry.
But I just drove 100 miles to get up here.
You should have given yourself more time for the drive.
Look, I'm sorry. That happens to be my fault. You see, my car broke down. I had to borrow my friend's bike. And you know how hard it is to ride a bike on the ice. Please give us a hand. I mean, I'm sorry.
I don't know.
Please, I really need the scholarship.
Let me check with the dean.
Thank you very much.
No promises, but I'll see what I can do.
Thank you.
You scared?
Yes.
Look, don't be, okay? You'll do fine. You're just the person they want, okay?
Thanks.
Dean Walsh will see you now, Miss Wexler.
Yes.
Thank you so much.
All right. Forget him, all right?
Huh? What's the matter? What's wrong? Nothing. I just can't believe that Jagger stood me up like this.
You guys had plans?
Yeah, I was, after he was gonna get off work, I was gonna show him that leather jacket. Remember that one I want to buy?
Yeah. Well, I'm sure he'll be home before the store closes.
I'm more mad at Karen.
Why? She didn't plan it.
You believe that?
Yeah, of course I do. I mean, her ride fell through with Jason and she was just in trouble.
Right. So she batted her eyes and asked Jagger for a drive.
No, Brenda, it didn't happen that way. Jagger offered to take her. She was totally surprised.
Great, Robin. That doesn't make me feel any better.
I just think he was just being nice, offering. He was just being a good friend, you know?
We have a lot to learn about guys.
What do you mean?
This little trip that Karen and Jagger took is about a lot more than friendship, Robin.
What?
I think that Karen has the hots for Jagger. And no guy is gonna pass up a girl who's throwing herself at him.
So what's this you're saying about Karen?
Hey, Jason.
I'll let you guys talk.
Yeah, excuse me.
So why do you think Karen has the hots for Jagger?
Jason, because it's true.
Okay, tell me what you know.
Come on, we've all seen the way they look at each other.
Come on, Brenda, you're grabbing at straws.
Do you really trust Jagger alone with Karen?
Yeah, sure. Why shouldn't I?
Well, for one thing, Jagger is attracted to Karen. That would be enough for most guys, Jason.
Karen and I are together. I trust her.
Oh, God. You're so naive.
Do you know what your problem is?
What? Spare me, okay? Because I don't trust your judgment.
No, see, this isn't about Karen and Jagger at all. This is about you and Jagger.
Oh, really? Why don't you fill me in?
Yeah, well, I think you're upset because Jagger's not as interested in you as you'd like him to be.
That would make things real simple for you, wouldn't it?
Why don't you worry about your own problems with Jagger instead of dumping them on me and Karen?
Thanks again, Dean Walsh.
Hey. Well, how'd it go?
It was great.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So, you got the scholarship, right?
I don't know yet, but he said, that I got a really, really good chance with my grades, my SAT scores, and everything, so...
Then, you got it.
Well, I don't know yet.
Well, congratulations. I'm proud of you.
Thank you.
There you go.
So what'd you do? Did you look around the campus?
Yeah, I went to shoot some pool.
Where'd you get that book?
At the library, they had a shelf of free books. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Well, you're gonna know this place better than I do.
Yeah.
But you'd like college.
Oh, yeah, Karen. I'm doing so good in high school.
No, wait a minute. The high school can be a drag, you know? You finish high school and you go to college.
No, wait, Karen. I don't have the patience for college, and I definitely don't have the bread.
Neither do I, but that's what scholarships are for.
Yeah, but you see, scholarships go to people with grades, like you.
No, all scholarships aren't for people with grades. Come on, it'd be so much fun to get out of Port Charles and come up here to school.
Yeah. Listen, I think we should go back to Port Charles, or else Ruby's gonna kill us. And I think there's a storm coming up, so...
Oh, Jagger, I just got warm.
I know, but you have to go back. Here's your books.
Thanks.
Let's go.
Are you sure we can't go any further, Jagger?
Not in the storm.
We're in the middle of nowhere.
I can see that, Karen.
I haven't seen a car for at least 20 minutes.
Look, I don't think anything could go through this except for a snowplow.
Well, what are we gonna do?
Karen, we have to find shelter before it gets too dark.
Jagger, there's nothing out here at
all.
There's
gotta be.
Come on, let's try and find something.
Okay, Karen, hold on. Just follow me, all right?
Okay.
Hey. What brings you by?
I miss you. I need a better reason than that?
Guess not. I heard that you stayed in your room at the hotel on New Year's Eve. Did you like it?
Yeah, it was nice enough.
Hoping maybe you're gonna move back in?
No, it was just for the night. You can go ahead and rent it out if you want.
Absolutely not. That's your room. I want you to know you have a place you can go to.
Julia, I'm not staying in the room.
What's wrong?
You okay? Yes. I've been better.
Yeah, me too. What's wrong?
Nothing, it's just that... Jagger was supposed to meet me and he didn't show up. Because, I don't know, he had to take Karen to some college interview.
Emergencies happen sometimes.
Right, and Karen's always there to take advantage of him.
Why are you jealous of Karen? Her and Jason are crazy about each other.
I'm not jealous of Karen. And she'd like everyone to believe that she's crazy about Jason. She even has Jason fooled.
But you think she's interested in Jagger?
I don't think, Julia. I know.
Well, do you think you should call the state troopers and see if there's been any accidents reported?
No, not yet. If the roads are icy, Jagger's probably driving real slow. At least he better be.
Well... I wish I could stay, but Felicia's trial's ending today, and I want to be home when she gets there.
Oh, that's right. How's the trial going?
Well, I don't know, but I'm sure scared for her.
Well, honey, we all are.
I know, but I know my Uncle Mac won't let anything bad happen to her.
Well, thank God for that.
But he said the snow's really bad, and there's no way anyone can travel on a motorcycle.
Well, so they probably pulled over on the side of the road.
Right. You probably checked into some cozy little motel room.
Shut up, Brenda.
Jason, I just don't like not knowing what's going on.
Yeah, well, either do I, but what can we do about it?
We can look for him. We can go look for him.
Are you serious?
Yes, Jason has a car.
No,
Jason?
No, this isn't going to accomplish anything, no.
Julia, it will accomplish something if we find them.
But you don't even know what route they took, and besides, you two would probably get stuck out in the storm, too.
Yeah, she's probably right.
Thank you for always being so sensible.
There are worse things in the world.
Flavish said call and let us know that they're all right.
Well, knowing Jagger, I bet they're still on the bike trying to get home.
God, Jason, wake up. They're obviously not trying to get home.
Hello? Anybody home?
Is there any signs of life?
Nope.
Let's go in. It's cold.
Be careful. It's a mess in here.
Awful in here.
Well, it's not the Ritz, but keep us away from the storm.
Yeah. Well, maybe we can please open the curtains or something.
Yeah, sure. Whew.
Oh, yeah, that's better. Now we can see how filthy it really is.
Well, any point in the storm, huh?
Well, I got first dibs on the bed.
No way.
Yes, I do. I called it.
Okay, so where am I going to sleep?
Well, I think you'll find someplace like the newspapers or something.
The newspapers, something? I think so. Hey, check this out.
What's that? What's so great about an old tin can?
Why don't you take a look?
Ah, oh, a candle.
Yeah. Let's see if I just... Should help a little bit.
Yeah, maybe. Oh, yeah, that feels nice.
Here.
What? No. You keep it.
Look, Jack. I want you to have it.
You're going to be cold.
No, I'm not cold at all. It's okay. I should keep you warm.
Thanks. You know, my mom and Ruby are going to be really worried about us when we don't come home tonight.
Well, there's nothing we can do about it.
I guess Brenda will be worried, too.
Brenda. She'll probably be ticked instead of worried.
Why?
Well, we're supposed to go out today, not tonight.
I don't think she'll be too mad, do you?
Well, if she is, she has to get over it.
You really like her that much?
Brenda? Sure, I like her all right, but,
But what?
I'm more concerned about keeping this fire going for tonight so we can be warm. Scared it's not gonna last.
Well, then we should probably save it.
Yeah. Yeah, you cold? I mean, there's still a draft coming from the door.
No, I'm fine.
Okay, good.
This does kind of remind me of being on the island.
Yeah, the only exception now is... it's just the two of us. Tired?
Yeah, I'm really beat. How about you?
Yeah.
We should hit the
sack and we have to get up early in the morning.
I know. What are we gonna do about sleeping?
Why don't you just get up for a second and
okay.
Maybe I can push this closer to the fireplace. Cold, so we're gonna have to share this.
I never dreamed that I'd love somebody like you. I never dreamed that I'd lose somebody.